Hello, traders. James Stanley with StoneX and FOREX.com. Wanted to look at gold at the outset of the week, as we had a really strong move show up at the end of last week. And so far this week, bulls appear to be stumbling a bit. Need to look at a risk disclaimer first. I'm going to leave this up for 15 seconds. It will also be up for 30 seconds on the back, and it will be in the description field of this video. Please review that. I'll be on the other side. We'll start looking at some charts. That's more than 15 on my watch. Let's get going. So first and foremost, I'm still in a fairly bullish spot on gold. And it's been an impressive year where coming into 2024, we were still seeing some interplay with the 2K level. But ever since the March breakout, there hasn't really been much for pullback. That March breakout ran through the Q2 open, and then we had the build of this bullish channel. So even that mean reversion had a bullish tint to it, as given the topside bias in that channel. The breakout from that in mid-August found support, prior resistance. But this is what I wanted to talk about today. This was the breakout that happened last month, and this was on the back of the European Central Bank rate decision, which might sound paradoxical to many, because if you look at gold, it's priced in USD. It's often considered to be the anti-dollar, or kind of the mirror image to the US dollar. But I talk about this a lot in these videos, where the US dollar is merely a composite of underlying currencies, 57.6% of which is the euro. So when we had the ECB announce that rate cut last month, that resolved roughly 3 weeks of mean reversion, range bound activity in gold to lead to that next breakout. Since then, buyers have remained aggressive and very active. We could see the ECB rate cut here a bit closer, and look at how sharp that move was, eventually leading to the 5600 test on the FOMC rate cut announcement. Now, that was the last or the previous, what I consider to be decent pullback in gold. When the Fed announced their 50 bip cut, price jumped to 2600 briefly, traded it for a few minutes, and then put in a sizable pullback. Sizable being $50 in a rather short period of time, or a little more than $50 in a short period of time. And then buyers just continued to press. Now, the reason that I think buyers began to stall in late September is proximity to that 2700 level. These psychological levels could play a really big role in gold's near-term price action, especially as we're at fresh or near fresh all-time highs. Now, since that failure to run through 5,700 or even test 5,700, we've seen a build of lower highs in here, which has so far continued. So I'm in a similar spot where I don't want to get bearish on gold because bulls have put up an amazing showing. Gold is still overbought on the weekly chart. It's still overbought on the monthly chart. But as I asked a few weeks ago, does that even matter? And near term, I don't think that it does. Now, it could matter eventually, but like we've seen in these runs, gold going overbought can get even more overbought. On a shorter term basis, that doesn't mean that I just want to chase price, hoping that it might work out, because there's always the risk of buying a top, or I might have to take on immense excursion against the position before the major trend continues to play out. And even if it does, it might lower high again. So from the perspective that I'm at now, I want to continue to look for pullbacks. The one that we saw last month was pretty attractive, but notice bulls did not even allow price to go back to that prior resistance. And that prior resistance was really well defined at like 25.30. And again, it held for a few weeks ahead of the ECB rate cut announcement. We have another ECB announcement this week. Bank is widely expected to cut rates again. The challenge around the ECB is they no longer issue forward guidance. So when they cut rates, we're largely going to have to read off of inference from Christine Lagarde as to whether they're looking at another one in the near term. Now, if there is a dovish overall take around the ECB, I think that's something that could further propel the top side of gold and maybe even get that 2700 test. But nonetheless, that's not attractive enough for me to just chase this and employ hope as the primary trading strategy. At this point, we've seen a pullback to, and this was really just the swing low that came into play after the weekly open. We've seen a pullback to that level that's so far been defended. I'd be cautious of chasing this one. A little bit deeper is a level that I find a bit more attractive at 2635. It's a level I've been following for a little while. Prior resistance, turn support, support again. Didn't really show much for resistance on the way back up, but a pullback there and a show of buyers defending that level opens the door for pullback potential. If that one doesn't hold, the 2622 is still of interest. Another similar level of prior resistance that came into play again last week after that initial sell-off and hold above 2600. If that doesn't come into play, if we drop a little bit deeper than that, 2616.96 is still of interest. And this was the level that I had looked at in the article, I believe it was last Thursday, when we had that pullback ahead of CPI or around CPI. Pullback to and defense of that level keeps the door open for bullish continuation potential. If we don't hold there, then I'm going to start to look for that retest of 26. But if we get the retest of 26, I'm going to start asking myself if we are seeing a change in near-term sentiment. Because I think one of the more attractive things about gold of late is just how aggressive buyers have remained to be. For instance, and going back to that breakout around ECB last month, that pullback held right here, right around 2550, a solid $20 above that prior resistance that was really well-defined. And that was a prior ATH. When we had the pullback last week, very clear support potential from prior resistance at 2600. Again, buyers would not even allow price to get down to that level. We saw a defense of the same higher low that came into play in the post-Fed breakout. So it's that buyer anticipation that illustrates the bullish behavior that I was speaking of earlier that's allowed for the overbought weekly reading, the overbought monthly reading, my reticence to even investigate the bearish side of this at this point. Now, taking a step back, the bull flag formation that I was looking at late last week, it's still in order. Now, the initial breakout from that has not run, but the bigger question is whether or not we could see bulls return to hold the higher low within one of these or around one of these prior swings to keep the door open for that next 2700 test or for that next test of resistance, which I'm looking to be around 2700. But that's what I have for this week. I'm going to look at this again tomorrow with some updated price action. And then Thursday is when we have the ECB rate announcement. Again, widely expected that they cut, but I think the bigger item is whether they're expected to cut again after Thursday. That's what I have for today. Thank you very much for your time. Hope you have a great rest of the week.